ओम तत्सत। वेलकम टू ज्ञान भक्ति चैनल फ्रॉम स्वामी निखिलानंद। माय हम्बल प्रोस्ट्रेशंस टू द ऑल परवेडिंग ब्रह्मन, टू माय वर्शिपफुल गुरुजी स्वामी ज्योतिर्मयानंद जी महाराज, टू राम परिवार, ऑल सेजेस एंड सेंट्स, एंड टू ईच ऑफ यू डिवाइन सोल वॉचिंग टूडेज सत्संग। वी आर करेंटली स्टडीइंग द होली स्क्रिप्चर मिस्टिसिज्म ऑफ रामायण, कॉमेंट्रीज बाय माई गुरुजी स्वामी ज्योतिर्मयानंद जी महाराज, नरेटेड बाय माई सेल्फ स्वामी निखिलानंद। सो टुडे इन टुडेज सत्संग वी विल स्टडी शिवा रिलेट्स टू उमा द एपिक स्टोरी ऑफ रामा। वन डे एज शिवा एंड उमा सैट रिलैक्स्ड इन देयर अबोर्ड इन कैलाश पर्वत, कैलाश माउंटेन, उमा एस्क्ड शिवा टू टेल हर अबाउट रामास इनकर्नेशन and his glorious deeds on earth. With his heart overflowing with divine love, Shiva told Uma the epic story of Rama, which forms the basis of the Ramayana of Saint Tulsidas, which we had covered in the earlier days. So we will move forward. It starts with the curse of sage Narada. The reason why Lord Vishnu incarnated as Rama, the son of King Dashrath and Queen Kaushalya, is conveyed in a colorful mystic story about sage Narada. This story relates what happened when the sage's intellect once became clouded by pride and delusion. Sage Narada is a symbol of satsang, but even sages and saints sometimes can come under the sway of Maya. Once upon a time, sage Narada was practicing deep meditation in a beautiful cave near the banks of the Ganges. Seeing the heights of samadhi attained by the sage, the celestial lord of gods, Indra, became apprehensive, thinking that Narada was practicing severe austerities to attain Indrahood or his throne. He therefore requested Kamadeva, the god of love, Cupid, to present temptations before the sage and thus to disturb his practice of austerity. We have heard the story with Kamadeva trying to do the same thing to Lord Shiva. Accordingly, Kamadeva, along with his attendants, exercised all their powers of allurement against the mind of Narada, but the sage remained unperturbed. When Narada could not be shaken, Kamadeva became afraid of the sage and, seeking his forgiveness, returned to his heavenly abode. Reflecting on these developments, a subtle pride arose in Narada. He thought to himself, "I have conquered Kamadeva. I have excelled many sages and saints who could not prevail against the celestial temptations." With such a sense of pride swelling within his heart, Narada went to Lord Shiva and related to him all that had happened, how Kamadeva had exercised all his powers and yet failed in his efforts. Lord Shiva smiled and said, "O Narada, you are a devotee of Lord Vishnu. By his grace, nothing is impossible for you. However, please do not relate this experience of yours to Lord Vishnu." But Sri Narada then went to Brahma, the creator, and told him how he defeated Kamadeva. Lord Brahma praised him also, but advised him not to relate this experience to Lord Vishnu. However, Narada did not heed to their advice and hastened to Vaikuntha, where Lord Vishnu dwelled. See, when pride and ego come up, they take their form in diverse ways and they delude us without even our conscious awareness. That is the lesson here. Lord Vishnu welcomed the sage and asked, "O sage, I have not seen you in a long time. Where have you been?" Sri Narada had then told everything about his confrontation with Kamadeva and concluded saying, "O Lord, it was all by your grace that I accomplished this most difficult task, a task in which even great sages of yore have failed." Lord Vishnu smiled and said, "Nothing is impossible for you, O sage. Kamadeva is no match for you." But realizing that Narada had developed pride and was falling prey to Maya or cosmic illusion, Lord Vishnu decided to cure him of his malady with the most ingenious scheme. So be careful here. When God wants to help us, guide us, He sometimes gives us adversities to shave off our pride, to humble us down a little bit, because when we are getting too egotistical, but we are sincere devotees, God will give us what's good for us, not necessarily what's pleasurable for us or what's convenient for us. It's important, as spiritual aspirants, we understand this important point. So departing from Lord Shiva, the sage resumed his normal habits of traveling throughout the various lokas of the world, which is what he does, travels everywhere and does satsanga. So soon he passed through a kingdom which he had never seen before. But this is all Lord Vishnu's maya now to teach Narada a lesson. A kingdom in which all the men and women were exceedingly handsome. The ruler of that king was of that kingdom was King Shilanidhi, and he had a beautiful daughter named Vishwamohini. That means enchanter of the world. The time had arrived for the beautiful princess to choose a suitable husband for herself. And for that purpose, her father had arranged a swayamvar. In those days, women picked their own husband by placing a garland in the neck, and several suitors used to be called up. According to this method of marriage, she could place the garland on the one she chose. Curious to find out more about that kingdom, Sri Narada went to the palace and introduced himself to the king. King Shilanidhi was delighted to have the company of the sage and brought his daughter before Narada so that the sage might give his blessings to her and foretell her future. When the sage looked at the astrological conditions of the princess and examined her palm, he realized that whoever married the princess would become the greatest in the world. He thought within himself, "Why shouldn't I become the blessed suitor of this glorious princess and attain supreme greatness?" Look at Maya and how the Maya catches hold of even sages and saints sometimes. So we have to be very cautious and very careful on our spiritual path. However, hiding his feelings, he told the king that his daughter was endowed with excellent qualities and that he gave his blessings to her. After seeing the princess, Narada's mind could find no rest. He thought within himself, "How am I to marry the princess?" See, now that thought has entered his mind. My austerity-toned body is thin and old and emaciated, and the princess would not be attracted to me. Soon an idea entered his mind, and Narada invoked the presence of Lord Vishnu, his best friend and benefactor, who would surely help him secure the hand of the princess. So he thought of Lord Vishnu. When Lord Vishnu appeared before him, shining in his divine glory, sage Narada said, "O Lord, you are the giver of all desires. I desire to marry Vishwamohini, the daughter of King Shilanidhi. For this purpose, I want to have a body just like yours, because it is only through your beauty that I could secure the princess for myself." Because Lord Vishnu is extremely enchanting, most handsome, and also the creator of this world, the sustainer of this world. Creator is Lord Brahmaji, Vishnuji is the sustainer, where there is all beauty and auspiciousness. So Lord Vishnu smiled at the power of his own maya, which had degraded the mind of the sage to such an extent, and said, "O sage, I will do all that is good for you." Thus saying, Lord Vishnu disappeared. Good for you doesn't necessarily mean the best what you think. It is good what God thinks. When Narada looked at him, he found his body transformed. He had the body of Lord Vishnu. Narada then hastened his steps to the Swayamvara hall, where kings and princes from many different lands had assembled, each desiring to win the hands of Princess Vishwamohini, the beautiful princess. Narada took a foremost seat so that the princess was sure to behold his beautiful personality. At the proper time, the princess entered the hall with a garland in her hands, her eyes moving eagerly in all directions in order to choose a husband. As she looked at him, she immediately recoiled from him and turned away. Thinking that perhaps she had missed seeing him, Narada moved to another seat closer to the princess. But the princess again turned away from him. Narada eagerly moved from one seat to another, and the princess continued to avoid him. All of a sudden, a dazzling figure entered the hall. It was Lord Vishnu himself, and the princess readily offered the garland to him. When the couple departed, Narada became increasingly distressed. At that time, there were two messengers of Lord Shiva, Shivaganas, who were amused at the strange behavior of the sage. Unable to contain their amusement, they whispered into his ears, "O sage, why don't you go and look at your face in that pool of water nearby?" Narada went to the pool and looked at himself, and to his horror and frustration, saw that he had the hideous face of a monkey. Though his body was most beautiful, this hideous head had created such a strange contrast that he became a ridiculous figure. So we will continue this journey in tomorrow's satsanga. So quite an interesting story about sage Narada and his illusion from his being a saint to an embodiment of Lord Vishnu and all the cycles. So we'll continue this story tomorrow. This is Swami Nikhilananda. Om Tat Sat.